Bomb. Last low, last half. Oh no. Last full.
Oh my god.
What a shot, man.
What the fuck, man?
Oh yeah, bitch. I've been doing well. See me make it plays. Yeah, I know that you can.
Hey guys, what's up? My name is X Media and this is my road to 10,000 keys. Anyway, before we get into the actual trades, finally I simply have to answer probably the most requested question of all. How and where can you get so many trades? Well, first of all, let me tell you something that isn't really a secret anymore. I literally get like 90% of my trades on trade servers, and about the rest 7% are from friend requests. And trust me, I get a lot of these. Anyway, I was pretty curious about the number of invites I got myself, so just for the sake of this video, I've decided not to accept any friend requests for about 2 weeks, and in total I've got well over 265 requests, including group invites, which I already ignored. Anyway, what I strongly recommend you to do is accept every single invite you receive. I mean, you never know what that guy might offer you. But yeah, last of all, I also get few trades just by listing my trades on sites like CSGO Lounge and CSGO subreddit. Now, I'm not saying it's useless. In fact, I got many really profitable trades just because of these sites. But in general, I usually get a ton of lowball offers. So I don't know, decide for yourself on this one. Hey guys, what's up to the first trade of this episode? Anyway, I bought this Huntsman knife a few days ago for 77 key spear, I believe. Anyway, I've managed to sell it for 86 key spear, which is in fact like 9 keys of clear profit. And also not mentioning, this knife dropped to 83 keys today, so definitely really good investment. Okay, so I was pretty damn lucky on this one. I found this guy on CSGO subreddit, and this guy added me like 5 minutes after I created the trade, and he's willing to pay my buyout, which is extremely, extremely lucky. So anyway, I'm waiting for him to accept the offer, and it should be done by now, I think. Yeah, so it just got accepted, and we've managed to sell our Medusa for a full price, basically. So this guy just came up to me with his M9 Vanilla, and he seems pretty dedicated of getting my gloves convoy field tested. And in fact, he wanted me to add like a bit more keys, but I've negotiated with him, and we made an agreement of my gloves plus 9 keys. So technically, I've made about 7 to 10 keys of clear profit on this trade, and also I've managed to get a pretty stable knife. So basically not long after, I've managed to find another guy who was willing to buy this M9 Vanilla I just got. And he was willing to pay with Bayonet Vanilla, and he also added a Vulcan Valvern, I believe. Which is about 3 to maybe 5 keys of profit, so yeah. Okay, so this guy, I'm assuming from CSGO Lounge, sent me an offer for his Bovi Crimson Bab field tested for my M9 Brightwater. Anyway, I've made about 5 keys on this trade, and also not to mention my knife was a bit wobbly in terms of price. So yeah, definitely a great trade. Okay, so I just got another offer for my Bayonet Vanilla, and he actually offered Bayonet Knight minimal wear. And I'm making like 3 keys, which isn't really much, but it's at least something. Okay, so right now I just went a bit risky, and I bought this Bayonet Gamma Doppler minimal wear for 135 keys, and I'm hoping to resell it for about 140 and possibly more. So yeah, I don't know how this will go because it's minimal wear, but I will see. So unfortunately for the last 6 trades of this episode, I won't be able to show you the trades directly, because when I was trying to reinstall my computer, I had to move them to my USB drive, and for some odd reason these files turned out to be corrupted. So in short, I have to record them once again. Anyway, in the first trade, I sold my useless scrap I had for Shadow Tigers Blue Steel, and I actually made about 1 key profit on this, which was pretty insane. But anyway, I've decided to quick sell my entire TF2 inventory for 270 TF2 keys. Now, this might seem like a pretty irrational decision to you because these items are like 480 keys, but to be honest, I've bought all these TF2 items for about 250 CSGO keys in knives, so I'm making about 100 to about 120 keys-ish profit in this trade, so definitely nothing to worry about, so yeah. And the next trade, I've exchanged all my TF2 keys for CSGO keys, and I actually got like 250-ish CSGO keys, I believe, which is really, really good. So right after this trade, I went straight into the trade server, and I actually managed to get this knife called M9 Stained for 85%. And this is like, I don't even know, 5 to 10 keys profit, which is definitely a really good start. In the last trade of this episode, I've decided to sell my Vulture Knife Safari Mesh for Shadow Dagger Safari Mesh. And to be honest, there isn't any real big difference in terms of value, but I liked Shadow Daggers a bit more, and he was willing to add the USP worth like one key, so yeah, I took it. Okay, so as already mentioned, this was the last trade of this episode, and right now we are at $3,057, and we have 9 knives and about 573 keys at the moment. Okay guys, so I'm not really sure when I will release the next episode, because from what I've seen, they're really demanded by you guys, obviously, but they take a lot of time, and yeah, I can't really do anything about it. But yeah guys, anyway, thanks for all the support. I met actually a few of you on a trade server the other day, and all of you seem genuinely nice and kind. So thanks for that also. Anyway, see you guys until the next one.